everything I've heard from the complaint, it's just totally false.
A man accused of breaking into homes, changing the locks, and claiming they're his, objecting today in court. Our investigation uncovered at least a dozen cases in which Robert Carr tries to gain ownership of abandoned or foreclosed properties. He admitted to WLWT News 5's Karen Johnson what he did to claim those properties. Karen leading the way again on this case, live at the Justice Center for us tonight. Hi, Karen.
And Mike, police now say Robert Carr was not working alone, at least not in one of the cases. The woman police identify as Carr's girlfriend is also here in jail tonight, charged with breaking and entering.
25-year-old Bethany Firth didn't have much to say as she faced a judge. Robert Carr, on the other hand.
First, I'm going to object to this whole proceeding. I don't consent to being identified as was named as a defendant.
Carr told the judge the complaint is false.
So.
And smiled when he was shown the documents.
The allegation is that you don't own the property where you work.
The courts say this house on Holderness Lane in Forest Park is owned by Evermore Mortgage. Carr and Firth are accused of breaking in. Carr even filed a quiet title action claiming the vacant house is now his. As our investigation found, he's done the same with 11 homes in Hamilton and Butler counties. When we tracked him down at another vacant home before his arrest.
I don't care about a deed. I don't need a deed.
Carr explained to us how his process works.
I have a team of people who go out and I say, make sure the house is empty. If it's empty, you know, change the locks.
He even hung no trespassing signs in the windows.
When you abandon something, you forfeit all your rights and title to it. And title is not a piece of paper. Title is when you grab and say, mine.
But now, in four of the cases, victims are fighting back, including the ones we focused on in our investigation. They returned to their house that was going into foreclosure to find locks changed and personal items removed.
He's got to pay for this. He can't keep this up.
And right now, Carr is being held here on a more than $40,000 bond. In the meantime, the civil courts will handle the quiet title actions. Reporting live tonight downtown, Karen Johnson, WLWT News 5.
And Carr is scheduled to be back in court next week to face the charges out of Springdale.